Today we're going to be talking about fire and acoustics. We need to first discuss what types of facades are there for that are suitable for high-rise. And how to choose types of facades, we need to talk about access for installation, because that will have a significant impact on how they perform acoustically and in terms of fire safety. How the movement and tolerances are accommodated, how facades are assembled, also have a significant role in the fire safety. I will probably only have time to talk about compartmentation of three or four types of facades. We'll discuss acoustics, especially for steel curtain wall. All of our courses, we don't give any attendance certificates. You're going to have to complete a test after this course, 15 to 20 questions. This is how the standard masonry brick assembly construction looks like. But the same outlook could be achieved with rainscreen cladding. This is a brick slip or precast concrete. So you can achieve the same look with all these three. What influences the choice of the system? If it's a high-rise tower in the center of the city, building the facade from scaffold is impractical. Precast or unitized, external access is not required. And that gap is a fire safety hazard. Fire stops will always be required in these instances. This is how it usually looks. That distance between the slab and the curtain wall should be large enough for you to position the fire stop. For the purposes of Applied Facade Engineering course, for the chapter on fire safety and compartmentation, we created a bay. We're going to remove the cladding and then we'll see what's happening behind it. Open state cavity barriers below and above windows, the shelf angle, a cavity barrier, brick ties, and cavity trays with weep holes. All of them are hard at work doing their own thing. A minimum 150 millimeter dimension lever from the anchor to the bottom of the slab. Also, you have to position your cavity closer in that zone. In most countries, the minimum size of the spandrel zone is mandated by the building regulations. It will act as an obstacle for the flame to leapfrog from one floor to another. There is a risk of flanking sound transmission in this configuration, especially in steel curtain wall facades. This could be managed by adding an acoustic insert within the hollow section of the mullion. This will reduce the sound reverberation within the hollow section of the profile. With unitized facade, it's possible to design them so that the mullions, nor transoms, span between the floors. So unitized facade, more risk-averse option when it comes to risk of flanking sound transmission. Other than your fire stops and everything else, you can have a ventilation outlet. You will have to fix the balcony structurally to the slab, and also arrange your accessible threshold level from the inside of the building, from flat to the balcony.